Will the success of The Witcher herald a golden age of game to TV adaptations? With their long, complex stories, video games fit television better than film, especially now streaming services have the firepower to make such projects. It is a truth, universally accepted, that video games do not translate well to the big screen. From Assassin's Creed to the Super Mario Bros. Movie, the result is usually a compromised monstrosity, ignorant of the source material and quickly disowned by the studios, directors and actors responsible for it. There have been exceptions. Detective Pikachu was weird but fine, and the Resident Evil films have their fans. But films based on games are usually a mess. Have licensing managers been looking at the wrong screen the whole time? This week, Netflix released viewing figures that showed its fantasy monster hunting series The Witcher is on course to be the platform's biggest ever opening season, viewed by more than 76 million households. There are question marks over how the company is now gathering its data. Netflix considers a view to have occurred when anyone watches for more than 2 minutes. It used to be 70% of the show. But even with such provisos in mind, The Witcher has been a success, performing well against veteran series such as The Crown, 73 million households. Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest. The show's makers have said the TV series is based more closely on the original fantasy novels by Andrzej Sapkowski than on the games, but let's be honest, it wasn't the books that got this series commissioned. The Witcher video game series has sold more than 40 million copies worldwide, and Henry Cavill's portrayal of lead character Geralt, who travels the mythical landscape slaughtering demonic beasts for cash, is highly influenced by the game's depiction. There are clear nods, too, to the game's fandom, most obviously in the bathing scene, whose game manifestation became a staple of The Witcher 3's marketing and memes. Fans' reactions to the series have been mixed, but they're clearly watching, which raises the possibility of further video game to television adaptations in the future. In a lot of ways, now that channels such as Amazon and Netflix have the capacity and expertise to commission such projects, video games make much more sense in TV than in film. Narrative games are a long-form medium, with stories that span tens, or even hundreds of hours of play. They feature many characters and plot lines that weave and intersect, often across sequential titles, a tough call for a movie studio looking to put out a 90-minute adaptation. Certainly, movies have successfully translated long novels, The Godfather, Misery and Great Expectations spring to mind, but those books have usually been built in ways amenable to film translation, with clear 3- or 5-act structure. For more on this story, visit the news article link.